वंदे मातरम गाइस, टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग अ न्यू चैप्टर एंड दैट्स अ न्यूक्ली. सो बिफोर वी आर गोइंग टू द डिस्कस अबाउट द न्यूक्लियस, फर्स्ट वी आर जस्ट कम्स टू द कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम सेक्शन. मीन्स हाउ मेनी क्वेश्चंस इज आस्किंग इन द प्रीवियस एग्जामिनेशन. सो आउट ऑफ दिस वन इन जेडब्ल्यू टोटल 58 क्वेश्चन इज आस्किंग इन अ 18 ईयर्स. सिमिलरली नीट एंड AIPMD टोटल 94 क्वेश्चन इज आस्किंग इन अ लास्ट 32 ईयर्स. सिमिलरली फॉर एम्स टोटल 94 क्वेश्चन इज आस्किंग इन अ 26 ईयर. ओके, आउट ऑफ दिस 94 क्वेश्चन 58 क्वेश्चन इज लाइक MCQ एंड 30 क्वेश्चन is like a assertion and reason type. Okay, so this is the quite helpful chapter for us for the competitive section. So you must be not this, and this is helpful to prepare a preparation of this chapter. Okay, now let's introduce this chapter. We already discussed about the atom. So in atom, as per the Rutherford alpha scattering experiment, size of here we discuss about this one, the size of atom upon size of nucleus is approximately 10 raised to 4 times. As per we already discussed about Rutherford alpha scattering experiment. Okay, and what is the conclusion of this? Size of atom upon size of nucleus means this ratio is approximately 10 raised to 4. And as per this experiment, atom is almost hollow. Almost hollow means all the mass and it's most of the positively charged. All the positively charged and most of the mass is concentrated at the center. Okay, and this center is named as nucleus. So this name nucleus is comes from the alpha scattering experiment, which is performed by the Geiger and Mason, and that's explained by the Rutherford. So this is the quite helpful thing to give the name of nucleus. Okay, then after in 1932 Chadwick performed some experiment, and after of this experiment thus one new particle in a nucleus is found, and that's a neutron. Okay, so this is called a discovery of a neutron, and we discuss about this experiment in detail. But as per this experiment, Chadwick calculated the conservation of energy and momentum. So by conservation of energy and momentum, Chadwick found the new particle inside the nucleus, and this is generally known as a discovery of neutron. So now after this experiment of Chadwick, thus the known thing is what? Nucleus contain the two particle, one is proton and second one is a neutron. So let's we are going to the structure of nucleus. Okay, so the next topic is structure of nucleus. Okay, how the proton and neutrons are inside this one. So you consider, suppose it is a nucleus. So nucleus consider nucleus having two particle, one is proton, one is neutron. Okay, so as we know, the proton is a positively charged particle. Okay, and similarly neutron is a neutral particle. Neutral particle means what? There is no charge. If you consider about the structure of nucleus, then there is a no charge. So you just simply denotes like this. Okay, so nucleus contain the two, one is proton and the second one is neutron. Proton positively charged particle, neutral particle, there is no charge. Actually atom contains the three particle, one is electron. Okay, but we discuss about we already discuss about in a atom. Now let's come to this proton and neutron. So number of proton inside the nucleus is generally denoted by Z. Number of proton is generally denoted by Z, and Z is also called atomic number. You must be remember this. Z is equal to number of proton, and that is equal to atomic number. Now you consider this both one, number of proton plus number of neutron. You must be noted this is both one, so that is called a, this a is called a number of nucleon. So actually nucleon is considered for both one. Proton is also in a nucleon and neutron is also in a nucleon. So number of proton plus number of neutron is equal to total number of nucleon, that is denotes by A. Sometimes A is also called atomic mass of nucleus. But this number of proton is how we denoted by Z. So plus number of neutron is equal to, denotes like this. So NN is equal to A minus Z. This A minus Z, it's denotes by the number of neutron. So you must be noted this. So the three things must be noted here. First one is number of proton, that's denoted by Z. Z is a atomic number also. Similarly, that's a number of nucleon. So number of nucleon is generally denoted by A. It's denoted by capital A. And the third one, number of neutron. Number of neutron is directly denoted by A minus Z. Okay, this is the symbolic form. So Z is atomic number, A is number, total number of nucleon, and A minus Z is a number of neutron. You must be note this one. Now, how to represent the any nucleus? That is a quite important thing. You must be understand this properly, because in a nuclear reaction, this representation of nucleus in this form. So there is a two way to represent the nucleus. So first way is which one? So first way, you represent nucleus like this, Z XA. Here Z is atomic number, A is a total number of nuclei, and this X is an element. Here X is what? Element, like a hydrogen, helium, lithium and everything. Okay. Similarly, second way, Z X. Actually, both symbols are used and both are correct. Okay. Here X is element, Z is atomic number, and A is a total number of nucleon. For an example, suppose you consider carbon. Okay. So for carbon, Z is equal to how much? 6. A is equal to, supposed to be considered, 12. So how you represent this carbon? So in the first method, you put here Z is equal to what? 6. So 6. X is any element. Here the carbon is used. So carbon is denoted by capital C. And A is a total atomic mass. How much it is? 12. So 6C, 12. You can represent like this, or you can represent in this way also, ZXA. So Z is how much? Z is how much for carbon? 6. And element is, X is replaced by C, and A is how much? 12. So 6C12. So you can represent in this both way. Maybe you are representing the carbon in this way or in this way. You maybe use any one of this method. Okay. So this is the representation of any nucleus. Okay. Now how to find the number of neutron here? Suppose you have to find the number of neutron in this example. So simply you can write down here, number of neutron is equal to A minus Z, so 12 minus 6 is equal to how much? 6. Some new example to find the number of neutron. See, suppose you consider the one example here, 80 Hg 198. You consider this one, 80 Hg 198, because here you the question is asking find the number of neutron in this element. Okay, in the Hg element, 80 Hg 198. So use the same expression here. So by this method, if you are using this method and this example, then your answer is what? See, 80 is what? Here this is 80 is replaced by Z, X is replaced by Hg, and A is replaced by 198. So you just compare this both. So what is Z here? 80. So Z is equal to 80. A is equal to 198. So number of neutron is equal to A minus Z. So 198 minus 8, you just count this. So 198 minus 80 is approximately 118. So our answer is number of neutron in Hg is equal to 118. So similar way you can finding out this. Okay. Now we have to denote the proton, neutron and electron also here. So that is a important thing, you must be note this. Okay, how you represent the proton, neutron and electron. That is a useful symbol. So for proton, you use this symbol, one p one, that is the symbol of proton in any nuclear reaction. Similarly for neutron, use this symbol 0 and 1, this is the symbol of neutron. And for electron, use this symbol -1 e 0, this is a like a symbolic form of this one. See, this is exactly like this symbol, see. Okay, but this is the useful symbol, proton, neutron and electron in any nuclear reaction. So you must be remember this three symbol also, because it is helpful to all of you. Okay, now all of you guys, you note this, so hold the things in your books. Okay, pause your screen and note down this one.